As 1863 began, the Union Army of the Potomac found itself in a general malaise. Its failed attempt at another push towards Richmond, known as the Mud March, had served as the nail in the coffin of Army Commander Ambrose E. Burnside. When Joseph Hooker took his place as commander of the Army of the Potomac, the changes he implemented helped boost the morale and the confidence of his troops. But Hooker squandered that goodwill by bungling the Chancellorsville Campaign in the early days of May 1863. While some believe that drunkenness or the artillery round that knocked him out for a short time were the probable causes of such bungling, Hooker himself told Major General Abner Doubleday while on the road to Gettysburg,
"I was not hurt by a shell, and I was not drunk.
For once, I lost confidence in Hooker, and that is all there was to it." After Chancellorsville, while Hooker was looking for ways to redeem himself, Robert E. Lee was setting the wheels in motion for his second invasion of the North. By mid-June, two great armies totaling somewhere around 150,000 men, with tens of thousands of horses and mules, miles of wagons, and in one of those armies, human beings that were owned by other human beings, marched into Pennsylvania. Meanwhile, everyday citizens in a bustling country town called Gettysburg were going about their daily business while reading about the war in any or all of the town's three newspapers. War had not left them untouched, however. Constant threats of invasion plagued them since they first sent their local militia, the Gettysburg Blues, to fight to preserve the Union in 1861.
By the 4th of July of 1863, this small town of 2,400 would be left with the daunting task of cleaning up the carnage and healing many times its number in wounded soldiers who wore both blue and gray.
On the last day of June, the lead elements of these two armies would be poised for the commencement of the greatest, bloodiest battle ever fought in the Western Hemisphere. But very few had any notion of that as they closed their eyes to sleep that night.